So in our practice, we've had some really smart patients come and ask us, hey, what is all this hand sanitizer and sanitizing surfaces actually going to do to our bodies long term? And it's a really smart question.
It is, because right now we're busy wiping everything down, scrubbing everything, sanitizing our hands, washing our hands. And did you know that we actually need this bacteria and this flora and these some viruses to help our immune system work properly, but also our gut, like for digestion? So I have a prediction.
Great, I wanna hear it.
That we're gonna see a lot of people that are gonna have a lot of digestive issues, whether that shows up as heartburn, indigestion, constipation, diarrhea, all the fun stuff that nobody wants to talk about. This is what we're gonna start seeing. And we know as researchers and as doctors that this happens when we don't have the proper flora in our gut.
Now, don't get us wrong. We know that there are certain standards that we have to abide by right now. We get that, right? We all get that. And we're all doing everything we can to keep everyone safe and our environment safe. However, we also need to do more so that we can have good gut health. Like you just said, we need to have good probiotics that we are continually ingesting to try to counteract what's going on the outside with this extreme sanitation. So, there are supplements, right, that you can take, probiotic supplements. My preference, though, is food sources, really good food sources of probiotics.
So you can look at any kind of fermented foods like pickles, sauerkraut, kimchi, what else can you think of?
Kefir, kombucha, those are all fermented foods that actually provide a really wide variety of great gut flora. Gotta watch the sugar load on some of them.
Yes.
But if you can get them in your food, even a bite of sauerkraut every day, a bite of fermented beets, or some of the ones you've already mentioned, just a bite a day will really, really help your body get through this time of extra depletion of our good bacteria.
And if none of that sounds appealing to you or good to you, you can also supplement with a probiotic.
Yeah.
Food would be our top, and then supplementation would be our next. And a quality supplementation, if you have questions about that, please ask. You want to look at one that has lots of different cultures and strains. So if you have questions about the other type of probiotic, the pill type, let us know.
See you soon.